Hi guys, this is another extra video in the joint series where I'm not making a joint, but I'm going to show you how to prepare a mitre in the end grain of a board. For example, if you are joining the top and the side on a bookcase or preparing the corner of a carcass. I should be using a little guide that I make up for when I need 45 degree angles. And you may have seen me use this in another video. It's very simple. It's just a batten with a 45 degree chamfer along one edge. And in fact, this one's got one on two edges. We don't need to use the mitre square to mark the ends, because for such a long cut, a little mark on the end isn't really going to help us. The way we do it is rely on the fact that around a right angle, a ratio of 1 to 1 will give us a 45 degree slope. And so I'll take my marking gauge, set it tightly on the width of the material, then I'll mark a line, a light line, on the inside or what's going to be the inside face of the bookshelf or cabinet. And I'll just highlight it in a few places with pencil so you can see where it is. Now, since I've got a mitre square, what I will do is check and knife a line across the far end, and that will help to avoid any tear out. So if I set that to the marking gauge line that I just made, and it matches the outside corner precisely, which is what we worked out it would do, knife that in. Now we're ready to plane it, so let's take it to the vise. Now the first thing I do when I've got the board in the vise is a little trick to avoid breaking out the material at the end. I've knifed it to begin with, which would help a little bit, but if we get a big catch on there we could break out a large section. What you can do is prepare the mitres first and then cut your boards to width, removing any of the damage. But we'll assume that we've already got the right width we want. So what I'm going to do is plane away the corner till I get down to the knife line, and I'm meeting the marked gauge line along the inside face and the outside edge of the board. Keep checking on progress so you don't go too far. What we've done is we've reached the mitre line right at the end. So when we're planing along in this direction, we've got good support until we get right down to the knife line. And when we're really close, we can then plane from both directions for the last few shavings. Now I'm going to turn the board around in the vise and do the main planing. Now you can clearly see the gauge line that is our target for the mitre. We want to plane right down to, but no further than that line. on this side of the component. On the other side, we don't want to remove any material from this far corner, but we want to plane just as far as there. That will produce a nice flat 45 degree face for the mitre. You don't need a plane any longer than the size of your component, but because mine is quite short, I'm going to be using a number 4 anyway. I'm going to set for a reasonable shaving, but this is oak and it's going to be quite brittle, I feel. Let's see how it goes. Now, I always find that if I try and guess 45 degrees, I invariably don't push the plane over enough. So I like to put my mitre square in front of me on the bench, just to give me something to aim at. And you can see I'm turning the plane a bit more to get roughly 45 degrees. Then we just balance it on the corner and start planing. That's a bit of a terrible noise, isn't it? Let's try and dampen down that noise by just clamping a block on the back. If you can get the work down lower in your vise, it would be better. But this is the best way I can demonstrate what I'm doing to you. So just initially hogging away a lot of material. And I'm now starting to gauge the distance between the gauged line and where I'm planing, and the outside edge and where I'm planing. And as we go down, those two distances should remain equal, and gradually getting smaller as we get closer to the gauge line and the outside edge. Getting very close here, you can see the back bevel I put on at the far end is getting very close to where I'm planing, and the outside edge and the knife line are getting close, a bit further away at this end. I'm just going to wax the sole of the plane. So a few stop shavings, try and bring this beginning down a bit further. I actually find it more difficult planing a mitre on such a short piece of material. The plane is, it wants a longer surface to ride on. Now I'm just going to reduce the depth of cut and gradually creep up on those, on the gauge line and the outside edge. Now you can continue until you get right to the gauge line, right to the outside edge, in this manner. Definitely when you're getting close to the end, start planing from the other side. so you do avoid any breakout there. But a little trick I use is to add a guide. This is where the little aid I showed you comes in, and I just clamp it so that the corner of its 45 degree bevel lines up with the outside edge of the workpiece. That's easier said than done, so just bear with me while I do that. Now I use the 45 on the little aid as the target that I'm aiming for. I can also see the gauge line, so I know I'm close there, but if I keep the plane, the non-cutting part of the plane, on this jig, I think you see initially I'm going to be cutting more at the top of the mitre, and gradually as I work down the plane should stop cutting when its outside edge of the sole is sitting on here. It shouldn't be able to go any further. So a little bit further to go. As you can see, I'm working from both ends to avoid any tear out. And I think I should be taking this plane to the stones after this. It's just starting to lose its edge. Almost there. And I think you may be able to see I'm just getting to the gauge line, and that's just coming flush with the aid. And the plane's now stopping and not cutting anymore. And there we have perfect mitre. If we prepared the other component like that, they'd go together, produce a right angle, and have a nice sharp joint all the way around. Thanks for watching. Perfect carcass mitres. Give them a go.